In our Science Advances article, we introduced an algorithm to implement the Neyman-Pearson classification as well as a graphical tool to illustrate the classification results. The Neyman-Pearson classification has broad applications in many fields. Here we will introduce its most important application in disease diagnosis. In this simple cartoon of the human population, we use colors to represent some medical test result that indicates a person's health status. The plus and minus signs indicate whether people have a disease or not. A fundamental question many clinicians face in medical practice is where to set a threshold on the test result so that they can predict whether a patient has a disease or not. A typical application is the diagnosis of cancers, where doctors need to predict whether a patient is likely to have cancer based on the test result. In such applications, false negative rate is a significant concern, because mispredicting a cancer patient as healthy will delay the treatment and may cause a life loss. Suppose that doctors would like to control the false negative rate under 1% while minimizing the false positive rate. What should be the diagnosis threshold? Here are five example thresholds, where people selected by each threshold will be diagnosed as diseased and will receive treatments. If we can observe the human population and the disease status of every person, setting the optimal threshold is easy. In this cartoon example, threshold 4 is the optimal one, because it controls the false negative rate under 1% while minimizing the false positive rate. However, in reality, we only observe a random sample of people from the population, for example, the patients with medical records. Doctors need to decide a diagnosis threshold based on these patients. A simple and intuitive approach is to set the threshold such that the false negative rate among these patients is under 1%. This approach will give us threshold 2, which however will give a false negative rate on the population equal to 7%. What if we observe another random sample of people? Now, this intuitive approach gives an even higher false negative rate on the population, 17%. One more random sample. Okay, this approach finally selects the optimal threshold 4, but as we have seen, there is no guarantee that the optimal threshold will be likely selected from a random sample. In fact, if we observe more and more random samples, we will see a distribution of the selected thresholds, and for about half the chance, we will choose a threshold that gives the false negative rate higher than 1% on the population. This result is not desirable. The Neyman-Pearson classification, in contrast to this intuitive but undesirable approach, is a theoretically justified approach to control the false negative rate under 1% on the population. The main contribution of our article is a practical algorithm to implement the Neyman-Pearson classification in real applications. Specifically in this disease diagnosis example, if we use the Neyman-Pearson classification approach to select the threshold from a random sample, our selected threshold will have a high chance that its false negative rate will be under 1% on the population. This desirable property will make the Neyman-Pearson classification an effective tool for choosing diagnosis thresholds in medical practices.